Listen, I think you should know that I'm,
I know.
Hmm.
Don't worry about it, okay?
Wait, the condoms are back in the tent, right? Okay. Well, a licensed love song would be playing right about now. But I've had it removed, and now other things are being removed. Get it on, Sean. More music. I guess that's what they use the generator for. The lights and the music. At least tonight.
Hey, what's up?
What's the matter, Sean?
Nothing, I just... Never mind.
Come on, talk to me.
Sorry, I, sorry it sucked.
Sean, This is your first time. I won't give you a bad review online. Promise.
That's, sweet, but you don't have to be like that.
Hey, I mean it, Sean. Just take it easy and you'll have time to practice, okay? Okay, we need some fresh air. Let's get dressed. Until we fuck again. Sean, it's all good, okay?
Hey, what's happening?
Wait. None of your business.
Did you guys just have sex?
Yeah. Kinda.
Kinda.
Yep.
Did you see Finn? He was with Daniel, but now I can't find him.
No, we were
didn't
busy.
See anybody out there. But...
Oh!
We better go now.
He took Daniel there anyway.
Figures Daniel is with him.
Just... tell Finn I want to talk. Thanks much. Later.
Sean, hold up. Wait a sec.
Why? We have to stop them.
Let's figure out a plan first.
We don't have time for that shit.
Well, we have to get to Merrill's before then.
You're right.
Do we have a vehicle?
Maybe we can borrow one of Big Joe's trucks.
Big Joe keeps a truck here at the campground or whatever this BLM land is.
This is so messed up.
I figured he just drove
I
it.
I told Daniel. Fucking Finn.
From the farm
hey,
to here.
Get mad later. We got shit to do now.
If something happens, fuck me.
It's okay. We're gonna get them. Bring them back.
Thanks for coming with me, Cassidy.
Don't thank me. I'm gonna kill Finn myself.
Oh, wow.
Can't believe it. We were gone, what? 10 minutes? 20?
Shh, don't holler. We don't want Big Joe to see us.
Big Joe live here, too?
Somebody build a lock.
On this land? Oh, of course. Yeah. Finn.
Probably got a checker card.
Probably Daniel with his power.
One truck is missing. See?
Mm-hmm.
Those tracks are headed out.
Fuck.
At least they didn't wake Big Joe up. But if we do, he'll kill us, Sean. So let's not advertise. No lights, no noise. Kay. I'll check the car, you do the truck.
Figures.
Locked.
Check the other door now. Daniel, what are you getting into?
Getting Sean, into bad stuff.
Check the car. All doors locked.
Maybe the car then?
That is the car. She said everything was locked.
Check it out. What? So, all the doors are locked. But we just gotta get into one car. And I think I can get that truck started.
You shitting me?
How do we get into it?
My dad was a mechanic. He once showed me how to hotwire his tow truck. Just in case.
Sean Diaz, you're full of surprises.
Plus, we could, mess with all the other cars, so Big Joe can't follow us.
Love the way you think.
Mess
we
with
can
them.
Find some things here to bust shit up. But we can't make a sound.
How are we gonna bust things up without making a sound?
I can wreck that engine. If I can open the hood.
Oh, the window? We're gonna wreck the window?
Man, focus. We have to get into that truck.
Here's a skull gearship. So we have to get into this truck. It is locked. Junk.
These bunch of pigs sure don't care about this place. Need to find something to slash these.
Okay.
Okay. Something sharp should do the job.
Rat poison.
Holy shit. That's why there's no critters around here.
Regu rat.
Fuck. Guess we won't be working here anymore. Finn is so fucking stupid.
I agree right now.
Nice.
Two of them. Oh, that inventory. Okay, boxes.
Nothing over here, man.
Bear skull.
Eco-friendly, my ass. They're just criminals.
We gotta slash those tires.
He's just right over there. This plan is crazy.
Crazy, man. Crazy.
Hurry up, Sean.
Oh, we looked in there already, right? What about the metal box? Now look at the other thing. Okay. Toolbox.
Gotta be something here I can use.
I bet there is. duct tape?
Forget it.
Screwdriver?
Might use that to force something open.
Oh, force open. Don't get electrocuted. It's like a... like a fuse box or something, I don't know. Oh no, it's a box with keys in it. Alright. So pick up the key. I just want to look around a little bit. There's obviously a key for one of the trucks. Oh, there's nothing much else to see. Tell you the truth.
Just gotta get in that truck and start her up.
Just want me back in my tent. I'm creeping out here.
With Sean. Alright, let's get in this.
Anything useful in this junk?
Yeah, a key.
Oh, yeah. Maybe this fits in one of the cars.
Like I said, office on it. Puncture tire. There's just these two vehicles? I think so.
There she blows.
You wanna puncture all of them? I would do all of them.
Damn. That was fun. Not gonna follow us now, motherfucker.
Window.
Wonder why he keeps that car here. Probably to get down to Arcata and pick up some girls.
I've heard it say Arcata and Arcata. Well, I don't think the keys are for this. I actually should have tried them first. That would be really stupid. We punctured the tires of, like, the keys were for this. That would be horrible.
By the way, Sean, that was nice being with you.
Thank you. Same for me.
Now let's get the hell out of here so we get another chance.
Okay, one moment. Puncture all four tires. Done. Try the keys.
Come on.
Oops. Force open. Now what about the hood though? Can I use this? Oh no, that was for the other car, right? Alright, we're gonna have to force it open then. Get the screwdriver. Oh no. Alright, stand by guys. I'll be right back. And then we'll figure this out. Okay.
God damn it, Daniel. I should have seen the signs. Dumbass.
Oh. Oh, there's a locker here. I didn't get in here, right?
How can I get this open?
I didn't notice that. Try the keys. Duh.
Score.
More duct tape.
Don't think I can use that.
Cartridge?
Man. That guy is really not joking.
Bullets, right?
Yeah.
Or rounds. A hammer. It's the only thing we need in here.
I could break shit with that.
Yeah, baby.
We're too slow, Sean.
Got it. And you're not doing anything.
Fuck. Let's get out of here quick, Sean.
No, wait.
Wait. He'll hear us. Give me a sec to figure this out.
Is she gonna leave without us?
Here goes. One, two.
Oops. Oops.
Shit! He's fucking coming! Let's go!
I had no idea it was on your property.
Ah, fuck, 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 fuck.
Well, we got a hot wire quickly.
He'll be on us in any second now. Fuck, Sean, you did it!
Let's get out of here. Drive!
Fuck this shit, we did it. But it was so close. Let's do this.
Huh. Okay. Didn't look like he was even trying to go for the other vehicle.
I don't like this shit at all.
Yeah. I just want to get this over with. If we make it.
Don't say that. Mm-hmm. Things can't go wrong after the night we've had. This is basic karma.
Shit. Right. I want this to continue, Cass.
We should go. They might not even be inside yet.
He still wants her to go with him. Because of course he does.
Oh, Finn is out of control.
Has he done this before?
Fuck us over? Not like this.
Why now?
Because Finn thinks Daniel is his golden ticket. He just gets greedy.
Jeez.
We gotta catch him. Oh man. I hope Meryl didn't hear them.
Wake up. His head looking down. I guess we're not supposed to be going in here.
Come on.
Sean.
Well, the office
is fine together.
Come here.
Promise.
How? What's Meryl gonna do if he catches them?
Finn's a smart bullshitter. He'll find a way out of this.
I know.
CCTV, wait.
Good. At least Meryl won't know anyone's coming.
Oh, it's off? No red light, I guess?
Ah, shit! You scared the shit out of me.
Good.
Yeah, good.
What the fuck? What are you doing? Didn't we settle this, man?
Shh! You're gonna wake Meryl! Finn, no fucking way. Come on, Sean! Are you kidding me? How could you do that, Finn? And you're some fucking kid.
He's 9 years old.
He asked me for it. I didn't force him, man. Are you an idiot? He's too young to make that kind of decision.
Fuck's sake, Finn.
He's an old soul.
Mm-mm.
He knows what's up. Hold on, please.
Can't use that.
You're standing near a boatload of cash. We can do this in 5 minutes, in and out. And then you're off to Mexico. You won't hear about me ever again. We got this, man.
It's a small world.
Trust me.
No means no, Finn. Meryl is right fucking there.
He's a log. Won't even know.
You asshole. I want to help, Sean. We could get out of here. Go to Mexico.
Mm-mm. I don't think we should do it. No way.
He said no fucking way, Sean. Please. We're done, Finn. Come on, Daniel.
No! Why should I? We couldn't even find you before. You were with her, right?
Who gives a shit? Let's go. Now.
No! I'm sick of all this. For weeks, you just hang out with her.
Can you blame us?
It's all your fault. I could do what I want.
Oh,
crazy!
That would wake up anybody.
The fuck are you doing here?
Shit.
Oh boy.
Don't move.
Don't shoot.
What the fuck? How many are you?
Just us.
It's just us.
All right, move your asses over there. Now!
Meryl,
thanks
boss.
A lot, Finn.
I know this looks bad, but...
Stop! I don't want to hear any more of your shit. So, What was your big fucking plan exactly? Work here for a time and then break into my safe? Pathetic. Who was the moron mastermind? Like I didn't know. I gave you punks work when nobody would. A place to crash for free.
God damn it, Finn, I told you—
Shut up!
Well, he gave us that land.
This is how you repay me? Stealing from me?
No, it's not about you.
I thought you were different, smart, but you're a real dumbass for getting a kid involved. And you're teaching him how to steal?
Nope.
Thief and brother of the year.
That's
nice.
Finn.
What now? You all really fucked up. I can't just let this slide. I can't. You're young, but you can learn from mistakes. That doesn't mean your lesson's gonna be easy or painless. Okay. On your knees. Hands on your head.
Shit, don't do this.
What's he gonna do?
Come on, sir.
Shoot one of us?
We could talk.
I'm serious. On your knees. Now.
Let's just do what he says, I guess.
Do what he says. Don't worry. We're on our knees, okay?
Meryl. No.
He's not.
Finn, just do it.
Don't break my balls now, kid.
He's gonna get himself shot.
You got this.
Don't move.
Just get on your damn knees.
Yeah, now.
He can't do this.
Don't fucking move. It's not like I want to do this.
Do what? What are you going to do?
The people I deal with are worse. But if you rip me off, you rip them off. Then I pay. I have a family to look after too. I gotta protect them first.
You gonna shoot one of us?
Can't let you play me anymore.
Sean.
Alright. Daniel, fine.
Daniel, do it! Get out! Run!
Out, son of a bitch!
Sean!
Ooh, ouch.
Wait!
Ooh, we got hit.
No! Fuck!
Well, that's not gonna do anyone any good. You're gonna bring the whole house down on everybody, including yourself. Daniel got hit in the shoulder or the arm? Is everybody still alive? Look at the money. He blew up the place and all the money went flying. Person laying there? It looks like there were screwdrivers or some kind of tool stuck in somebody. Is she breathing? Is that a bullet hole in her? Or just a hole? I don't see any blood from her. Or from Meryl. Is everyone just knocked out, or are they dead? Tens and twenties? Okay, where's Daniel and Sean? Traveling. Is that something in his eye? You're kidding me. It stops like this? Oh my god. You gotta be kidding me. You have got to be kidding me. So Sean has something flew into his eye. The other, Meryl, Cassidy, and Finn, dead or unconscious. Can't tell. And where's Daniel? And eventually, Big Joe's gonna show up, right? Good God. Well, the choices are coming up. That's crazy. And just left on a complete cliffhanger like that. So if we hadn't had Daniel use his power, would Daniel have used his power anyway? Like, push would come to shove and he would have used it anyway? That's my guess. What was Meryl going to do to teach one of them, to teach them a lesson? Kill one of them? I mean, obviously not kill all of them, because that's not teaching anyone a lesson. You don't learn something if you're dead. Okay, our choices. You made coffee for the others after drinking the last cup. It's like half and half, 50%. You hit the target while knife throwing. Oh, wow. Nobody did not hit the target. So that's almost half and half. Slightly more, I hit the bullseye. It's a little tough. 87%. You try to be understanding when Daniel mentioned Karen. That's a good choice. You ask Daniel why he doesn't wear his watch. 84%. You intervened when Big Joe slapped Cassidy. Yeah, majority. 73%. You didn't trim very efficiently. Your trimming was average. Yeah, I sucked at that. You helped Daniel clean the dishes, 70%. You were wasted at the campfire. Slightly more than half. You stayed up late and got a haircut. Okay. Most people went to sleep with Daniel early. You came forward when Daniel hit Big Joe. Ooh, excuse me. 64%. You were out for the heist. 63%. You and Finn remain friends. 86%. Finn kissed. Yeah, no thanks. You chose to have a wolf tattooed. 66% majority. Let Cassidy choose your tattoo. I wonder what tattoo it would have been. You went to the lake and had a midnight swim with Cassidy. 83%. Cassie didn't get angry with you. Or at you. 85%. You kissed Cassidy. 62%. You went into Cassidy's tent. 54%. Slightly more than half. You sabotaged Big Joe's vehicle so he wouldn't come after you. Yeah, that would have made it even harder, right? You woke up Big Joe and he went after you. 16%. You came in after Finn and Daniel broke into Merrill's house. 74%. Also, we could have come in at the same time or before they did, I guess. But most people just did what we did. 74%. You didn't take the gun from the safe. Well, that's what was in there? There was a gun and money? You told Daniel to use his power and Finn wasn't killed. Oh, that's a spoiler, Ellen. Most people, yeah. Most people had enough at that point and told Daniel to use his power. Nobody shot Merrill, causing Finn to be killed. 9% did nothing and Finn was killed. 5% did nothing and Finn wasn't killed. Okay. Cassidy was injured. Oh no. Okay, so we know she wasn't killed. This is a spoiler. Daniel waited for you in the morning. 77%. Daniel had your help doing the dishes. 71%. Daniel refused help. Wow. Guess you really piss him off. Daniel refused to help with the water tanks. No, he didn't. I just didn't have him use his power. Better off to carry them because people would have saw him. He didn't refuse to help. He was going to help us. And then we picked up one of the water tanks and all of a sudden he was gone. Daniel went to sleep alone. Daniel talked. I guess instead of getting the tattoo, we talked with Sean about his anger. Daniel talked with Sean about it, about Daniel's anger, right? Daniel used his power, got injured, and lashed out. 86%. Other options are Daniel disobeying, using his power, and getting injured. Daniel stayed put, but lashed out after Finn died. We didn't have Finn dead this time. Finn was shot dead, and Daniel lashed out at Sean. Wow. Only imagine that. 2%. That's a pretty brutal happening. Pretty brutal event.
This is it, son. You're toast.
I am?
End of the road.
Okay.
No way out this time. We got a lot of room in jail for cop murderers like you.
Uh-oh.
You're alone now. Alone.
Is he? Daniel's nowhere to be found? Oh, that's gonna be rough. Gotta find Daniel next episode, I suppose. Wow. What a turn of events. Anyway, thanks so much for watching, guys. See you in episode 4, Faith. Thanks for watching. See you then, and always, seek adventure.